so far. We just had a little blip in cable there, up to 134.21, as you can see on this hourly chart. You kind of have to wonder if there's going to be some sort of news coming out. It was a bit of an unusual move. Not sure if the market just got caught short, clearing out a few stops, or this is real, but Euro Sterling broke back through the 200-day, which was at the figure, and we'll just have to see. We talked about that Sterling Swiss level, which I think is very important in the longer scope of things, 133.33. I don't know. Not too much going on so far, but we're keeping our eyes out for news. Let's quickly move back down to the Aussie. We got what we wanted this morning. Printed a low of 20. Now we're in consolidation mode here, sideways. Should be sideways between sort of 25 and 45. And perhaps we'll get an extension lower to our target around 95 figure later on today. Euro at the lows. Printed 78, which is just a pip below yesterday's low. We're trading there 79 now. This is all Euro Sterling driven. Really don't know what to make of this, but we did not get paid up between 10 and 20, so we're square Euro, just kind of watching. Dollar Swiss just grinding higher in a very, very quiet, small range kind of a morning. Principles are the same. We try and pick up Dollar Swiss on weakness. And we'll go into the US numbers long today. Dollar Yen kind of the same. Same type of deal. We've got our core longs. And we're looking to add through 112.86. There are supposed to be some offers at 80. God knows if that's true or not, or what's going to happen with that, but we remember very clearly Tuesday's price action at 85, where we tried it and tried it and tried it, and the offers won. So now we're basically using that as our barometer, bear bull barometer, going into the New York session. Kiwi, as you could guess, is offered with Aussie and CAD being offered. The next important low is 17. It'll be down quite a bit on the day when we get down there, so I'm not going to chase it down there. And we're just going to see if we get a good print, maybe for something tomorrow over non-farms, if we can get that steady. Gold continues to go lower, which kind of dovetails on our stronger dollar theme. 5486 cash gold is the low, lingering at that low now. Quickly, Euro Sterling. This was the low on the 5th, 87.76. An important low is 55. Prices below 55, we feel, are going to create an extension. Ideally, this is on Sterling News if it goes through. We'll have to see if we get follow through on this. This hour has been pretty powerful so far, but still 17 minutes left in this hour, so we'll have to see where we close. Just as a refresher, here's our Sterling Swiss chart, 133.33. We like it. It's up through that on news. There is lots of clear air. First real resistance comes at basically 100 points higher at 134.2030, and this is a key technical setup. All right, I won't bore you with anything else. We got a little bit of New York numbers, and we got to keep in mind that non-farms tomorrow, typically violent. So let's try and get ourselves long dollars with a comfort level so that we can go into the numbers long tomorrow and see what comes up then. Anyway, Sterling's in focus as I close this video. Cable went back down to 97, but now is 10 bid. Have to wonder if we're going to see some news in the next hour or so out of the UK. Oftentimes these little mysterious moves front run real news. So keeping our eyes open and see what happens. Good luck out there, people, and we'll see you tomorrow for the European Open. Thank you. Bye-bye.